Hi, I thought I'd do a video about the torches I use when I'm above ground and when I'm below ground. As you're well aware, there's a vast array of torches, starting from pennies up to sky's the limit. You could actually sell your soul to buy some of these torches that are out on the market now. I've started off quite modestly, so I just thought I'd give an honest appraisal of what I've got at the moment. And another little section I'd like to do is about batteries, another minefield when you first start out with torches, but that will come later. Right, first up is this torch. I bought this torch many moons ago from a well-known auction site. It had a... Yes, I think before we go any further, I think we should, from now on until a bit later, I think we should refer to the lumens that I quote as, how can I put this, Chinese lumens. I think that's the way we're going to go. We'll call this Chinese lumens. So anyway, when I bought this torch, it was rated at 5,000 lumens, and it's a Cree XML T6 Ultrafire. I'll just give you a minute to stop laughing. Yes, like I say, mega lumens apparently. But no. However, I've had this torch for 2 or 3 years. It's seen plenty of hammer. Still works, as you can see. I won't blind you with it. I will be doing a test of these outside later when it's dark. But yes, I wouldn't even like to guess how many lumens this torch. Actually, I've got to say, I've got two of them. And the only difference is, one's got a silver bezel at the end and the other one's black. I think this one was rated rather similarly as well. And of course they've got both got the zoom function, blah, blah, blah. Well, this one did. It's not very happy at the minute. Oh, there it goes, a bit stiff. Oh, I think it's got a bit of sand in it. But I do find these very useful in everyday use for work, and they're even handy down the tunnels and stuff, really, to be fair. And you can pick these up for, I don't know, £5 or £6 from eBay delivered. The one thing I have done, they come supplied with a battery carrier. I think it's for AAAs. First thing I do is just shove them in the kitchen drawer and replace it with a 18650 battery. This one's carrying an 18650 battery as well. So there's those two. The next two are also very cheap. This one is a white light. This was rated at 5,000 lumens. Again, we're sort of talking about Chinese lumens here. And we're not talking about reality. However, it's a very good thrower for the price. And I paid, delivered without a battery, £4.29. Aluminium, so nice and strong, you can drop it, and it's a brilliant little thrower, really, you know, for the price. Again, I'll test this later on when it gets dark, just to show. This one's also called an XML T6 by Vastfire, VA-C8. So that's that one. I run that on an 18650, as this one. This is exactly the same torch, but it has a red LED. Now, I bought this primarily because now and again I like to do a bit of rat shooting, and you need a nice red light because rats can't see red light apparently, so I like to mount this on the scope of my air rifle. However, when I last went out down a tunnel, I took it and I took some arty-farty pictures using this red light as sort of a backlight through a window frame and some graffiti. I sort of enjoyed it so much, I've actually ordered another one of these for £5.29 with a green LED in it, just for the lighting effect, because I do like taking photographs as well as exploring. So, yep, like I say, this one is rated at 5,000 lumens, as is its brother, and I should have a green one on its way. It is on its way. So yeah, I'd recommend these. You know, they're all right for the exploring. And like I say, this white one really, really does throw the light well for the price. So you can't really go wrong. Right. This is this is a Sunray King. It runs off 4 18650 batteries. And there's no light in it, batteries in it at the moment. I'll put them in later. Now this one, stand by for a laugh. This one apparently is rated at 32,000 lumens. Now, anybody who knows anything about torches will know that that is a falsehood. There is absolutely no way whatsoever this thing kicks out 32,000 lumens. I bought this a while back before I knew anything about torches. I will say it cost me £17.50 delivered. It's, you know, aluminium spun. And I've lubricated the threads with Vaseline. You know, it's well constructed. You get a lanyard with it, which I binned and put some proper paracord on it. It gives that a really good floodlight. I use this torch in my Monkton Farley tunnels and, well, all of my tunnel videos actually. For the money, £17.50, no brainer. I would recommend it, but don't expect the retina burning 32,000 lumens, because that's never going to happen. And then after that, I thought, oh, that's a nice little flood, I'll get another one. This is also Sky Ray King. However, this one is four LEDs, and obviously it throws a lot better than its multi-LED'd brother, as you can see. This one was also about £17.50 delivered. This one is rated at 8,500 lumens. Obviously, you must have tears running down your face by now, the people who know about torches, because there's no way this kicks out 8,500 lumens. Not in my humble opinion, anyway. For the money, it's a good little thrower. I'll demonstrate it later, of course, but I'm quite happy with it. It's well constructed, just like the other one was. So I'm not going to complain about it at all. I'd recommend buying one, but don't expect to be dazzled. Oh, my other one I must mention, I like to have as a backup, is just these, one of these sort of cheap, I think I paid a tenner for it on eBay or Facebook or something like this. This runs off 2 18650 batteries and has various different modes. You can, you know, hang on, see if I can get it to zoom like this. You can get it to pan out like that. You can get all these side LED lights to work. Sort of thing. I don't want to blind you, but yeah, again, it's quite a bulky sort of headlight sort of thing, and you have a little red sort of tail light, if you like, when you're walking along. You can always stick some tape over it if you don't want it, but I do find it handy to have in the bag, and for the cost of these things, no brainer. Then I started watching more videos about exploring and stuff, and I sort of saw some of the equipment that some of these more sort of professional explorers use, and I thought, oh, I like the look of that torch. So I went out and bought this one, which is a LED Lenser P7, the 2018 model. This one goes up to 450 lumens, I believe, and we're not talking Chinese lumens now, we're talking real life lumens. So I managed to get this from a company on Amazon. It was listed as second hand, and I believe it was Cash Converters in Concept, and I managed to get this for 22 quid. And when it arrived, I sort of opened it was like brand new. The batteries were still in the box, and I've got the box upstairs, but all the batteries are in it unopened, all the instructions, blah blah blah. You could see someone had opened the box prior. So anyway, I got the these LED lenses seem to have like a little, I don't know if you can quite see it, but it's got like a little number a code number on the side. So I actually emailed Led Lenzo and asked him if it was genuine. And they promptly got back to me within 20 minutes and saying, yep, that's our latest model. You've got a good torch there. So I have to say, this little torch is a pocket rocket. Love it. It's got several modes, which I'll demonstrate later when it's dark. But this one, maximum, is obviously zoomable. And it goes up to 450 lumens. And I love this torch. If you can pick one of these P7s up, this will do the job that this one has been doing. Honestly, it's brighter. Quality torch, but I do worry about dropping it because I'm a bit anal when it comes to sort of scratching decent stuff. I like to look after my equipment, but recommend this torch 1,000,000%. The only thing I would say, I would like it if I could stick a 18650 battery in it. This one runs off 4 AAA rechargeables. Now, I've not run it down to flat, so I can't really tell you from past experience how long it lasts, but I always take a spare set of batteries anyway, and it's never ever looked like it's going to give up the ghost. So would recommend this torch totally. Oh, and I must add, I'm not being sponsored or endorsed by any of these companies. This is just a straight up down to earth review of these different bits. If they were crap, I'll tell you, trust me. But the next one, so I thought, oh, that's a nice torch. I'm going to buy another one. I want to replace the thrower with a slightly better quality torch. And then this one's perfectly adequate, but I just wanted something with a bit of oomph. So I saw this one on a YouTube video and I thought, oh, I fancy a bit of that. So this is the Thru-Night V6 catapult thrower, mini thrower. Oh, I meant to say, the pouch on this is built like a brick outhouse, so I'd recommend the pouch. It's really solid, and yet when you open the Thru-Night, the pouch is adequate, I would say, but it just, you know, you can see the difference. It feels really flimsy, not of the same quality, to be fair. I'd much prefer it to be like this, thicker. So if you're watching Thru-Night by any some fluke, please improve the sort of feel and quality of your pouches, because it, you know, you spend a fair bit of money. I can't remember how much I paid for this. How much was this? 70 odd quid plus? And I would have sort of expected a better pouch, to be fair. But anyway, that's just a minor thing, really. Right, this torch. Yeah, this torch. Where do we go with this? This runs off their 26650 battery, which they supply with it. And that's 5,000 milliamps, I think, per hour. This one is rated at 1,700 lumens. I'm really, I went back down the Monkton Farley Tunnel with this torch a few days ago just to take pictures of the graffiti and this, that and the other. Man, oh man. Yeah, well, look, that's turbo. And I like the little blue light that, I don't know if you can see this, hang on, let's get this right. I don't know if you can see the little blue light that comes on when you've got the torch switch on. I really like that. I used this up the Monkton Farley Tunnel. I wanged it on turbo just to see what the kick was. Well, if the tunnel hadn't had an upward slope, I think I could have seen to the end of the tunnel and beyond. Amazing. Can't really find words for this torch. I will demonstrate it later. It's got the USB charging port on the side. Rightly or wrongly, I prefer to take my batteries out and charge them. I've got a Nightcore charger upstairs that I use, so I prefer to charge them in the charger so I can keep an eye on the battery. And I've actually bought, I don't know if I can get it out. Ow. Now, I've actually bought a spare to go with this because this is the dog's danglers, this torch. I bought a Keep Power 5,200 milliamp hour battery, and that was 10 quid delivered, I think, something like that. And they even sent you a little box to go with it, which is nice because I like to sort of store my batteries away, as you can see. I can't recommend this torch enough. The Through Night Catapult V6. I'll show you it later. If you can afford one, buy one. Trust me. Right, and that's all of my sort of torch fleet, really. I am dreaming about a big, powerful torch, but that's, you know, got to save up for that. And the next little thing, and I hasten to add at this point, I'm no expert when it comes to batteries. However, the last couple of months that I've been doing these sort of exploring videos, I've learned very quickly, you know, and this is no sort of attack on any particular company, but I've learned very quickly there's no point having a good torch or even a shit torch if you've got shit batteries. Very steep and quick learning curve. Now, you see all these adverts for 18650 batteries, Ultrafire, for example. That's one company, and there's another company, a GTF. And you get sort of these ones, these sort of, that's my yellow tape, but you get these ones in just these blue, yellow, red sleeves. And I learned very quickly that they don't give out, well, it appears to me that they don't give out the power that they claim, because these batteries don't last long at all in something like this. Not even at full chat, they just don't last the course. Now, I got very suspicious of these sort of cheaper batteries, so I made it my business to sort of, and don't get me wrong, I've got 16 of these cheaper batteries, so I still use them, because obviously I'm going to screw every last sort of ounce of juice out of them and until they die. Because I was a little bit suspicious of these batteries, I've managed to find some videos on YouTube, and these guys actually test these batteries. They're obviously electronic wizards, and they test these batteries, and they don't give any, like this one for example, claims that it gives out 5,300 milliamp hour power. Not a chance. Some of these were only giving out 800 when they were fully charged, new. And then they started weighing these batteries and sort of, you know, stating the difference between different batteries. And I thought, well, I'll try that with my own. So I've got my scours here. I'm just waiting for it to sort of settle down. There we go. Now, if I weigh one of these Ultrafire, this is a TR18650 5,300 milliamp hour battery, 3.7 volts. So I'll weigh this one. That one weighs 35 and a half grams, apparently. This is made by, well, this is a GTF 9,800 milliamp hour battery. This is a TR18650 3.7 battery. Now, this one feels very much lighter. Bearing in mind that the stated claim is 9,800 milliamp hour. 28 and a half grams. Now, this is what I would class a decent set of batteries. These are by Keep Power. This is an 18650, 3,500 milliamp hour battery, 3.7 volts, blah, blah, blah. Let's weigh this one. 49.2 grams. Now, as I've said, I'm no expert when it comes to batteries. All I do is use them in a torch, switch the torch on, and hopefully the batteries last until I finish using the torch, like everybody else does. However, on at least one occasion, in this torch, and I haven't even had it on full chat, these Ultrafires, I've had to swap the batteries after 20 minutes, half an hour. Then I've put these Keep Power batteries in, that weigh so much more, the difference is astounding. And I've never had to replace them on a trip out, never, 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 never. So in future I'm going to be buying these Keep Powers, because they are the dog's danglers. Just like the spare you know, for my V6 thrower thing, that's a keep power. All of my batteries now are going to be keep powers when I need to replace them. So this was just a shortish video, just sort of explaining the batteries batteries and torches that I use. I'm not saying go and spend £1 million on a torch. I just use these because I don't really want to spend a fortune on torches, and these sort of at the moment do the job. I have to say though, I don't regret buying the LED Lenser. Recommend this little torch. I can't vouch for the older one. They've got the older P7 and they've got a P7.2, but neither of those give out the lumens that this one does. This is the P7 2018 and it kicks out a max of 450. I don't know what all the other technical bits and pieces are. I'm no expert, but I could just tell you from using it, you want to buy one. And this, this is, like I say, the Thru-Knight V6 Catapult Mini Thrower. I just like just holding it and looking at it. God. Yeah, baby. I just like it. It's well constructed. It just feels like it should cost a lot of money, and for what it, the size of it, it does cost a lot of money, but I do like it. Like I say, the only drawback with it is this pouch. Me not keen on the pouch. I think they could have done a better job. I don't know, it's just like they've missed off the end of perfection in my view. So Thru-Knight, no attack on your torch whatsoever, but the pouch, you could improve it. Anyway, I shall come back a bit later when it's dark, and I shall review the torch. Well, I'll let you review the torches, in fact. I'll just shine them at somewhere as far away as possible, and you can make your own minds up. But I'm sure you'll like the LED Lenser and the Thru-Knight, like I do. But like I say, please don't just write these off as crap. In my opinion, they don't give out the lumens that they stay, nowhere close. But for cheap, what I call cheap working torches for exploring, you don't need the posh badges on the side of them. They'll do the business. For £17.50, this is 32,000 lumens and this one's 8.5. Yeah, I'll let you reach your own conclusions when you see the video later. Another thing I meant to say about these torches, the pain in the arse thing about them is if you've got them in your pocket, they like to switch on. They haven't got a lock off, I don't think. Well, I've not found one because obviously they're cheap and cheerful torches, really. But that is a pain in the arse. They do switch on. And the last thing you want to do is get to a location that you've just driven to that's taken hour and a half or so, in my case, and find that one of the torches has been on the entire time in your bag, and you have to change the batteries before you can even set foot outside your car. So my advice actually on these, not the others, just these particular torches, is don't put the batteries in until you get to where you're going. Right, I shall catch you later. I don't know whether to make this a separate video. Either way, I shall catch you later and show you the torches in the dark.